Fill the bottle
with water. Just make sure that there's no air in the bottle. Okay. Then we put the hose into the bottle and turn on the ER50. So now we have Brown's gas going into the bottle. Replace it and the water ejects itself. So now everything in the bottle will be only Brown's gas. No air. Okay, once all the water is out of the bottle, then we put a cap on the bottle. And we set the bottle aside.
Say when you're ready.
Say when you're ready.
Okay, I'm recording. There we go.
There we go. That was it.
And now we'll ignite the 15-minute one. Nothing. No. This is an experiment. We've never done it before. My buddy over here is holding his ears in case it explodes. There we go. I heard a little ping and that was it.
Yeah.
Air pressure is moving in on it.
Okay.
Can you see the water boiling?
Yep. Yeah.
Can you see the water boiling?
Yep. Yeah.
See the water boiling in there? Now as the steam cools. The bottle starts to collapse.
Just to show you the igniter system that I've been using, what I did is took one of the bottle caps and drilled a couple holes that just fit test lead, which I cut in half, and then I had the two clips at the bottom, and used a little hot glue in the to seal on that side, and then some hot glue to seal on this side. I knotted the wire and then pulled it right into the hot glue. So I made a pretty good seal, and bared the wires a little bit so that I could put the test clips from the battery on it. And then for the little wire that I put down here so that it would glow and ignite the gas, I just took a piece of stranded wire with very, very fine strands, and I'm sorry that the camera's not focusing as well as it should. but then you can just pick out one little tiny strand and put it on the test clips. So you can pretty easily make an igniter like that.